Hey everyone, Justin here with KOAT. I'm standing with Chris from Hotel Andalus, and a very touching situation right now. And we actually just spoke a little bit ago, and you called this an emotional roller coaster. You found a letter.
I did, yeah.
And tell me about what this letter is and how you found it.
Well, I was actually just this morning walking here downtown over at Third and Copper, and this envelope was sitting there on the ground, and so I picked it up to actually throw it away to pick up some trash, and flipped it over, and it says My Joe on the other side, and it was still sealed, so nobody had read it. So we continued over, did what I was out to do, came back, decided we should open it up to make sure it wasn't something important that we could get to somebody, and then it's a really heartfelt letter from a dad to his son Joe. And Joe obviously hasn't read it because it was sealed, and we really feel like Joe needs to hear from his dad, and so we're trying to find Joe, basically.
And we don't know who Joe is, of course. I mean,
there's no
indication of a last name. Even the dad who wrote this letter, he signed it off as dad.
So yeah.
We have really no idea who dad is or who Joe is.
Nope.
But I mean, we both read it, and it is incredibly touching.
It's extremely touching. As a father myself, and as a son who lost his father, it really pulls at your heartstrings. It's mm-hmm. really something. It's, and again, because it didn't make it well, or it hasn't been read by who it was intended to be read by. Joe hasn't read this letter. Joe needs to read this letter. Mm-hmm. It's very touching. It really, really is.
Yeah, and I know, I mean, there's, you know, several paragraphs here. I mean, any sentence that really stood out to you? I mean, I'm trying, you know, to recall when I read this letter. I mean, I think, you know, right down here, I mean...
Well, this part really, I found really touching, the whole thing's touching, but mm-hmm. where it says, please forgive me, the times I wasn't present or I didn't say what I felt. I can't remember us having real problems. I know there were times when I annoyed you. Chalk it up to me being a dad. I always wanted to give you everything, but I always had so little to give. I guilted out about not being able to take you places and show you things that I'd seen. I apologize if I let you down. I'm sorry, and please know that I would never have hurt you intentionally. Nothing's ever made me prouder than you. Yeah, it's incredibly tough. And as a father, that's, you know, I totally feel that exact same thing towards my daughters. It's just so touching, and I want to help this father get this to his son.
Yeah, and the other thing too, I mean, obviously it talks about, you know, maybe dying, not being afraid to die. So I mean, we don't really know what the situation is besides perhaps dad is sick. So hopefully we can find Joe. I mean, as you saw on the envelope, all it said was Joe on it. And then, if you don't mind, let me just show you this real quick.
Right.
I mean, at the top, it just says Joe. It has a letter, and then it's signed by Dad at the very bottom. And that's the only information we have is Joe and Dad. And we need to find Joe so he can get his letter, because it is very touching. So I'll have more on the story tonight for you at 10 o'clock. And let's help find Joe so he can get his letter.